Yeah, John, more details were unveiled tonight about the east-west connector under construction in Anderson County, and some neighbors got fired up about it. News 4's Mandy Gaither live tonight in our Anderson newsroom. Mandy, some feel they were kept in the dark about the plan.
Well, that's right, Carol. The original plan was for a two-lane road, but construction started and that changed to a four-lane road with a turning lane. And some neighbors say a four-lane road is not needed or wanted there.
The east-west connector is already under construction. 3 miles with 13 places to get off and on, meant to lessen traffic on nearby roads by connecting Highway 81 at the Ingalls to Clemson Boulevard by Grady's Outdoors. But some say the project is getting out of hand.
Excuse me, but you are not hearing us.
For those who live around the area where the connector is being built, concerns over quality of life and developers eyeing the area for shops and restaurants had them speaking out at a meeting where the new expanded four-lane plan was unveiled.
All you're hearing is money, money, money. It costs this number of dollars now. It will cost that much in dollars then. But what about the people who live there? How is this helping us?
The project was first proposed back in the 90s, but funding was always a roadblock. Federal highway stimulus dollars are now paying for it, but the project went from two lanes to four when an unexpected $4 million from the extension of the highway bill came into play.
And if this decision was made in February, and we were not made aware of those decisions that were being made, I am personally offended by that as a taxpayer.
We're going broke. Why do we have to work? To me, it's a waste of money right now. It should go on something else where it's totally needed. I don't believe it's needed right now on this project.
Eddie Adams, the 3rd District Commissioner for the Department of Transportation, says the Anderson Area Transportation Study, called ANATS, always planned to have this roadway four lanes. That's why the rights of way were purchased in the first place.
Unfortunately, up until now, it's been about funding, and now we've come up with the money and it's an opportunity to get it done.
The road was to be completed by October 2011. If approved for four lanes, it'll probably add on another year.
And before it can be approved as a four-lane road, ANATS has to vote to approve it. They're expected to do that at their next meeting, August 16th at 12:30 at Anderson City Hall. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.